Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm gonna teach you how to budget using Dave Ramsey's Every Dollar app. So if you wanna learn how to budget like a pro, keep watching.
All right, here we are at everydollar.com. You can actually use the desktop version of the app or just go to the App Store and download Every Dollar directly. I'm going to be using the desktop version for this tutorial since it's easier and bigger to see, but there really is no difference between features and functionality of the two. One's just on your phone and one's on a computer. So if you haven't already, go ahead and create an account. I'm going to assume you'll know how to put in your name and email address and sign up for things. So after that, let's go and sign in. Since this is my first time creating a budget, you are going to be brought up to the current month and everything is going to be blank. So I'm going to click this Create October Budget button. And what this does, this brings up a template of some very common items that the majority of everyone has. And it's a great template for starting your budget and getting everything off to the right foot. So Every Dollar is based on the zero-based budget philosophy, which basically that all of your income minus your expenses equals zero every single month. So what you're gonna be doing is you're gonna be counting for all the income coming in, and then you're gonna give every dollar a home in the budget. So there's not gonna be months where you have an extra $200, $300 just floating around. So with zero-based budgeting, you are forced to put that somewhere, even if it's just putting it into savings. So let's get started. The very first section that you need to fill out is the money coming in or your income. And there are two ways that you can do this. You can either lump everything into one line item. So let's say in this example, I get paid weekly and I get paid $1,000. So I can either just have one line item like this and just put $4,000. And then every time I get paid, I can just click and drag it to that section. Or you can actually split it out paycheck by paycheck. I prefer to do it this way because it allows me to easily add new paychecks. When there's months where there are 5 weeks, you can just click and add a fifth week and then put the number right in there. And then on your next month's budget, you can just go ahead and delete it. Versus if you are adding it all in one paycheck, normally people don't have nice round numbers that they are getting paid. So then you have to do some sort of calculations. And for me, it's just easier to know that, hey, this is what I'm getting paid every single week and go from there. So in this example, I have $4,000 that I am getting paid. Now, as part of the zero-based budget, it is my job to find every dollar a home. All right, let's go ahead and get started with this. The very first section is giving. And so this is if you pay tithing to your church. So I'm just going to put that I pay a 10% tithing. So you can just go and put that in there. So the next section is savings. And you can see that this is a fund because it has this little piggy bank next to it. I'm not going to actually go in and put any money in this fund yet because I still need to budget for like my food and my water and my mortgage. But in this example, let's say that I'm on baby step one, which is to have a $1,000 emergency fund. If you're not familiar with the baby steps, you can go here on this menu on the left-hand side and it will actually walk you through the different baby steps and it actually knows which one you are in based on your budget, which is pretty cool. So let's say that for my emergency fund, I want to have a savings goal of $1,000. So you just go right there and you save that. And let's say that I already have $500. Now, the great thing about these funds is that it remembers month to month how much is in here. So if I'm able to add money to this fund this month, next month, let's say I add $100, next month it will show the starting balance as $600. And then it will help me get to my goal. Now, with these other funds, you can add other funds. Let's say I want to do a Christmas fund. And any item that you add isn't automatically going to appear as a fund, but what you do is you click on it and then right here, you click make this a fund, click the button. And let's say I want to do $500 for Christmas, right? So you can do a variety of different funds, vacation fund, emergency fund, Christmas fund, whatever works for you. But again, since I have debt and I haven't really allocated any money, I'm not gonna put any money in these funds yet because if I scroll down, I still need to pay my mortgage. So here is your big housing section. In this example, let's say that I have a mortgage. So you can just click on it and you can rename these or delete or add things and you can make these categories work for you. These are the ones that are most common, so that's why they populate. In this example, my mortgage is $750. My water bill is $50. Let's say I don't have natural gas, so that's not something I have to deal with. $100 for electricity. I'm going to do cable/internet since those are bundled. and 125. And trash, I'm just gonna delete trash because in this example, I don't have that. I'm gonna add another item. I'm gonna add home maintenance because I am a homeowner. Sometimes there are things that come up. So let's say I'm gonna be working on my lawn this month and I'm just going to allocate $50 for that because that needs to happen this month. So as you are putting in the different amounts of what you're planning to spend during the month, you'll notice that it is subtracting up at the top. So I started with $4,000 and it's letting me know that I still have $2,525 left to budget. So I need to make sure that all of that, this eventually goes down to zero. So for transportation, I'm going to put 125. That's just gas getting me around town. Maintenance, I'm just going to put, you know, $10. For me, maintenance is, you know, car washes and things like that. I mean, I could put a separate one for car washes or whatnot. All right, the next category is food, and it has these two categories right here. There's groceries and restaurants, and I like that these are broken up because groceries are kind of the basic things that you need to live, and restaurants are more fun, nice to have things, but not necessities. So in this example, let's say I use $500 on groceries for my family, and I'm actually going to leave restaurants blank right now because I don't know if there's going to be enough money in this budget to go out to eat this month. And let's talk about budgeting. You know, let's say your goal is $500, but just month over month, you're not hitting it, and you're realistically spending more like $600, right? You need to be honest and open with your budget and realize that you might need to up certain areas or decrease certain areas. If you're budgeting, you know, higher than you need, then the next month, maybe drop it down a little bit. So that's the nice thing about the budget. But you do need to remember that if you are upping something, it's going to have to come from somewhere else. So just be aware of that. The next section is personal. So these are things, clothing, phone, fun money, hair, cosmetics, subscriptions. So since I know that I still have $1,000 to pay off on my credit card, I'm not going to allocate anything for clothing or anything fun. I know that I do have a hair appointment this month. I'm going to get my hair cut and colored. It's going to be $100. I'm hoping that can happen, but depending on what's left at the end, we'll see if I might have to cut that. Lifestyle, these are for things, it's kind of similar to personal, but it's things that are kind of associated with you, your pets, your children. So pets, children, entertainment, that's kind of broad. Some people like to switch that out. You can put movies, and I'm going to put sports. And now when you are using every dollar, you click these six dots on one of the line items or up at the main category and you can move those around. So let's say I want to put sports next to movies, and I'm going to add a section called back to school, even though it's October, let's just pretend. And I'm going to move that up kind of by the kids. It's back to school time. We're going to have $150 for back to school clothes and supplies. Now there is this category here called miscellaneous, and this is actually one of my favorite categories because even though you are doing the budget and you are doing your best to try and anticipate what you will be spending and needing over the month, for me, I find that there are things that I end up having to buy that I don't necessarily plan on or think about at the beginning. So I like this miscellaneous category because it's kind of a catch-all for those. So I'm just going to say $150 for kind of catch-all spending and we'll go from there. Health, this is things like the gym, doctor's visits, medicine. Let's say I go to the gym and it's $100 a month, but I'm not planning on having these two expenses this month. And this last section, this is different types of insurance. These are pretty standard month to month. So I'm just gonna throw in some example numbers here. Let's say my home and auto insurance is just bundled into the same payment. I'm gonna get rid of this. And I don't need identity theft insurance, so I'm gonna delete that. All right, now we are to the very last section, which is debt. To keep this example simple, we'll just say that the only debt that I have is a credit card payment. So you can click on that. And then I'm gonna add the starting balance of the credit card to $1,000, okay? I'm not gonna mess with any of these ones right now. Now remember, since I'm in baby step one, I actually need to go and create a $1,000 emergency fund before I even start tackling any of the debt. So I'm gonna go down to that emergency fund. I have $500 in it already. So I have $810 left of my budget. So I'm just gonna put $500 there. Perfect. Now I have $310 left for my credit card, so I can go ahead and put all $310 right there. But going back and looking at some of my other items, you know, I really want to get that credit card down and paid off, so I don't want to deal with that. So I'm actually going to get rid of my hair appointment this week. And I don't know, let's just put $510 for groceries. Let's see if I can use some coupons and spend less on groceries this month. So now that actually allows me to have $500 to put toward my credit card payment, which is half. So I'll put $500 towards this, and then my goal next month will be to pay it off entirely. The very last section here, if you have very unique needs for your family that don't fall into these main categories, you can add a group, and then you can add different items underneath each one of those. All right, now you can see that there is a green check mark up here by the date, and it says it's an every dollar budget, which means that every dollar has a home, every single dollar is accounted for, which is really, really exciting. All right, you can see here on the right-hand side, there is a little pie chart that has a breakdown of all the money you are spending for the month. Again, we have $4,000 and here's where it is going. About 13% is going to debt, about 13% is going to savings, and 27% is going to housing. So that's where the good majority is going. So that's a lot of money to be going to some of these other things like debt and savings, which means that, you know, you don't have a lot of extra money to do fun things like go out to restaurants. This month, I couldn't get my hair cut. You have to sacrifice. And that's just the reality of when you're in debt, is that you don't have money to do these things. And that's what I really love about doing this budget, is it makes it really, really clear where all of your money is and where it's going. So another thing that I want to call out with every dollar, if you have categories that you spend a lot, you can just click on it. And there's a little star right here, and you click add to favorites group. And now it creates a new section right underneath income called favorites. So these are things that maybe if I'm going to the grocery store every week, or, you know, another one that I can add, I'm going to add, you know, gas for my car, because I'm probably filling up once a week. And I'm going to add miscellaneous, because it seems like miscellaneous things kind of always appear. So now let's go up here to these transactions. So if you click on the accounts button, this is actually going to bring up a prompt to try Every Dollar Plus. We are using the free version of Every Dollar, which means that I have to manually put in all of the transactions during the month. But what Every Dollar Plus does, it connects with your bank and it automatically pulls in the transactions. And I'm going to show you an example of kind of what that looks like. And it makes it so easy, because all you literally have to do is drag and drop, and then you could do your budgeting and put everything in their categories within 60 seconds and be on your way. So I really would recommend doing this. You can try it for 15 days free. And trust me, you will not want to go back. It is $100 for a year or $10 a month. But I find by having this convenience, it saves me a lot more time. And I actually end up saving a lot more money because I'm sticking to my budget. It's making it so easy. So for me, the $100 a year is totally, totally worth it. All right, so now let's go to the transactions section. Go up to the top left corner, click this plus sign. And this is where, since we are using the free version, we're gonna have to manually go in and put some of these transactions. So you click add new, and I'm gonna do an income first. So let's say that I'm getting paid on the first Friday of the month, and I'm just gonna put employer. And then what you do is you choose where you want this to go. So this is gonna be paycheck one, and you click track income. So you can see right here, before they have these gray lines underneath it, that means there's nothing in there. But when it's all the way green, it means that you have completely filled up 100% that section. So I was expecting to get paid $1,000, and I did get paid $1,000. So let's go in and add a few other transactions. So next we're gonna click expense. And let's say that I did $100 on this date, and I'll just say grocery store. And then you click, and since I already saved groceries as a favorite, it's right there, and you just click and do that. And you can see when I scroll down to groceries, the bar is about more or less 1/5 of the way completed. I spent $100 and my goal for the month is $510. So now I'm gonna show you an example of splitting an expense. Let's say I pulled $150 out of my bank. So I'll just put bank ATM. So let's say that I spent this money on two different things. So you're first gonna click the first thing that you spend it on. Let's say that I paid my phone, and then it will pop up add a split. So then you go and you add your second item. So let's say that I spent the second on back to school. Okay, so my phone bill was $50, so I'm gonna put that there. And you can see that it says, it leaves this zero and says $100 remaining. You can actually click on the $100 remaining, and it will automatically fill it out for you, which is super nice, or you can just type it in. And let's say you did even more things with this, you can continue to add even more splits and split things up that way. All right, here are some sample transactions that I created. And if you want them to appear uncategorized when you are creating the transaction, you just don't assign it to a budget item. So anything unassigned will appear right here. Now, if you have Every Dollar Plus, this is what it's going to look like when you log into your app. Anything that you have spent, it is automatically going to pull these transactions in. So it makes it really easy to actually start doing the budget as you go. So now all I have to do is drag and drop. So my first one is that credit card payment. And then my gym payment, just drag that, health insurance, drag that right there. And you can see the green line is going the whole way. Now I did this to show an example. I went to Costco, I spent $450, which is crazy. And you can see because I'd only anticipated spending $510 and I spent $550. So it's showing this red bar indicating that I have overspent in this category. So in this example, I'm really gonna have to look back at my budget and see where I can cut things. So maybe that back to school, I spent $100 and maybe I can't afford to do anything else and maybe we can buy the other things that we need later. So the last thing I'm going to do is I'm just gonna categorize my mortgage. So that is how you create your budget and then how you load the transactions. And I wanna show you one more thing before we go. So let's say that I'm getting ready to do my November budget now. So you just click this little button right here, this little down arrow, and click November. And it's going to basically clone last month's budget. So click start planning for November. And you'll notice that it pre-populates the things from last month. So all the categories and the amounts that I had last month, it's going to automatically have those in there. This is really nice because once you get going, there are a large majority of items that are the same month over month. You know, your different health insurance or insurance premiums, those are probably the same. Your mortgage or your rent is the same. So the nice thing about it cloning the budget is that a lot of the items are already pre-filled and then you can go in and simply change different items based on what you think. So let's say, for example, now I paid off my credit card. So that is zero in this example, which is awesome, which leaves me so much more money each month to do some of these other things. So I can go back up and back to school. That was a one-time expense. I'm just going to go ahead and delete that. Now I have money to do my hair appointment. And I'm gonna go back up and for the remaining money, let's say that everything else is good for this month and is not gonna change. So I'm gonna go back up here to my emergency fund. And remember, I started with $500. I added $500 last month. So now my emergency fund is fully funded. So I don't need to put any money in here right now. So let's say I've moved on to the baby step. I already completed baby step one. Now, actually all my debts are paid off. In this example, it's showing the current month. So it still thinks I haven't paid everything else off. So now I would be saving for 3 to 6 months of expenses in November. So I'm actually just going to throw all that money that's left, $1,060, into creating this second emergency fund. So baby step one is you create kind of a baby emergency fund. And then baby step three is to create an emergency fund of 3 to 6 months expenses. And you just go from there.
All right, so that is how you create a budget using Every Dollar. I personally love Every Dollar, use it every single day. I get so excited when new transactions come in and I get to drag and drop them to their different locations. So I hope you found this helpful. If you did, and you're gonna start budgeting using Every Dollar, be sure to give this video a like and subscribe. And of course, check out these two other videos for more helpful tips on social media, marketing, and how to manage your life. See you guys.